So the ultimate goal is to understand inflammatory bowel disease to the extent whereby we can develop new therapeutics where we can target those treatments towards particular individuals. So our research so far has centered around trying to identify these particular regions of the genome that increase susceptibility to Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. And we've done that using not just genome-wide association studies using SNP arrays, but also more recently using next-generation sequencing technologies. What we found from that actually is that we're not necessarily just identifying missense coding variants that are underlying these diseases. So what we're finding is that many of these variants, they have their effect on Crohn's disease by changing the expression levels of a nearby gene, and we need to try and identify what that nearby gene is. By combining our genetic associations with these EQTL data and finding these co-localizations, we're able to start understanding the genes that are important in IBD risk and also the cell types. What we've been starting to do is to look at creating EQTL maps from immune cells that are resident inside the gastrointestinal tract. Because when we've performed our transcriptional studies and we've compared the transcriptomes of, let's say, CD4 T cells in the blood versus the transcriptomes of CD4 T cells in the gut, we've found regions of the genome that differ, despite the fact they're in the same cell types. If we were only undertaking genome-wide association studies, or we were only undertaking DNA sequencing experiments, we'd be doing very well at identifying variants that are associated with disease. What would be the roadblock, though, is understanding, okay, once we've identified that association, what's it telling us about disease biology? How does that particular genetic variant go about increasing risk of Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis? And for that, we need to use other additional technologies. We need to be looking at the transcriptomes of disease-relevant cell types. We need to be looking, certainly in Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, at the microbiota variation. We need to be doing longitudinal sampling to understand how the transcriptome of the cells alters throughout the disease course. And so it's only by using these integrated technologies that we're able to maximize our insights into the disease biology and ultimately to understand how we get from genetic variant through disease biology and how that then affects kind of immunology and normal functioning of the individual. Discovering something that was previously unknown, designing an experiment that allows you to answer an important question about biology that before you started out with the experiment was unknown, it was a mystery. To make those novel discoveries, and that moment when you realize that you're onto something new, that you've found out something new about a disease that is affecting many hundreds of thousands of people, is very rewarding.